respected chairpersons and learned audience. I presented topic a comparative study on barley and oats and its effect on weight loss and nutritional parameters. Nowadays, changes in dietary practices, lifestyles, along with reduced physical activities rising with influence contribute to increasing prevalence of overweight in all the age groups of society. Obesity has reached epidemic proportion in India in 21st century, with morbid obesity affecting 5% of the country's population. The National Health Foundation of India undertook a study amongst the higher middle class, lower middle class in a large office establishment and amongst the poor class from a slum in Delhi. As against obesity of 1% for male and 4% for female in slum, the corresponding figure in the upper middle class and middle class together were 32.3% and 50%. More females than males have been found to be overweight in all age groups, 44.5% in females versus 19.6% in male. Incidence of obesity was higher in people above 40 years. The prevalence of obesity was about 3% in male and about 14% in females above 40 years of age. 20 million Indians are obese and by 2025 expected number of 68 million. Obesity existing when adipose tissues comprises greater than normal functions of body weight. The measurement of body fat is too complex to be practical clinical application. Hence, measures such as critical index, also known as BMI, are used in daily practices. The World Health Organization guidelines define a BMI of 18.5 to 24.9 kg per square meter as normal, 25 to 29.9 kg per square meter as grade 1 overweight, and greater than 30 kg per square meter as grade 2 overweight. With this in mind, the International Diabetes Federation has accepted BMI value of greater than 25 kg per square meter and 23 kg per square meter as a cutoff of obesity for Asian men and women respectively. So for the present study, the patient having BMI greater than 23 are included. With the current back to nature thrust, many obese patients also look for some help from traditional systems like Ayurveda. Traditionally, obesity was believed to be associated with lifestyle. Several studies have shown that changes in dietary pattern, physical activities levels, lifestyles, and related to increasing function frequencies of obesity and the risk of associated diseases. Present work was conducted on barley and oat, yava and jai. Many preparations of barley are reported for wide use of weight reducing diet like sattu, laja, etc. Ayurvedic texts prefer yava over jai because oat is considered as a kudhanya. The drug or ahar which will reduce or scrape away the unwanted dhatus, malas, and thus helpful in removing extra fat is known as a lekhan karma. वी कैन कोरिलेट द लेखन विथ अदर कर्मास ऑन टू बेसिस. फर्स्ट इज एज कंसर्न विथ द धातुस मेटाबॉलिज्म, लेखन इज अपतर्पण कर्म एंड इट इज सिमिलर टू लंघन. रिमूवल और स्क्रैपिंग ऑफ अनवॉन्टेड दोष धातु एंड मला, वी कैन से छेदन इज वेरी मच सिमिलर टू लेखन. लंघन, रुक्षण एंड स्वेदन आर इंक्लूडेड अंडर द बोर टर्म. अपतर्पण मीन्स डिप्लेशन ऑफ द बॉडी टिश्यू. द लेखन कर्म इज ऑल्सो नोन एज अपतर्पण कर्म एज अ बॉडी टिश्यू आर रिड्यूस इन लेखन टू. लंघन इज ए प्रोसीजर विच कॉज लाइटनेस ऑफ द बॉडी. वी कैन से लंघन एंड कर्षण कवर्स द मीनिंग, दिस मीनिंग. एम्स एंड ऑब्जेक्ट्स ऑफ दिस स्टडी, टू फाइंड द इजिली अवेलेबल एंड चीप न्यूट्रिशनल डाइट हैविंग लेखन प्रॉपर्टी एंड हेल्पफुल टू मेंटेन द बॉडी वेट. To conduct a randomized clinical trial in order to evaluate lekhan karma of Yava and Jai in overweight or obese. To compare the results of both groups. This is the plant of Yava, barley, and this is the seeds of barley. This is the plant of Jai, oats, and this is the seeds of Jai. It is almost similar. Material and method. 56 patients were recruited in the trial. Group A, Yava flour, 150 gram daily, once in a day in a form of roti, chapati. Group B, Jai flour, 150 gram daily, once in a day, the form of chapati. Criteria for assessment, BMI, weight differences, difference in pratyatma lakshanam, laboratory investigations. Anthropometry, measurements like body weight, height, waist circumferences and hip girth were recorded. The indices of BMI and waist circumferences, waist hip ratio were calculated from recorded measures, body fat measurements. Biochemical, several biochemical parameters like blood glucose, total cholesterol, HDL, LDL, VLDL, triglyceride were assessed. Trial durations, 8 weeks, 2 months. Results, nutritional value, you can see both are having good nutritional values. Effect of Yava on anthroparametric parameters. So you can see that it is very good, means extremely significant on BMI, BMR, waist and hip circumferences. Effect of Yava on laboratory parameters. It is also very good on VLDL, LDL, HDL and triglyceride also. Effect of Yava on Pratyatma Lakshan means the subjective parameters. It is very good on Alasya, Gaurava, etc. Subjective parameters, it extremely significant. Effect of Jaya in anthroparametric parameters. It is also significant in BMI, BMR and weight. Effect of Jaya on laboratory parameters. It is significant on cholesterol, triglyceride, etc. Effect of Jaya in Pratyatma Lakshanam. It is also effective on Gaurava. This is the comparative comparison of both Yava and Java. You can see in all results, you can see Yava is more effective. Discussion. By comparing this result, we can say that both Yava and Jai were having lekhana effect and can be used as anti-obesity diet in routine. During this study, no any allergic condition or side effects were reported by subjects. Effect of Yava and Jai on anthropometric parameters and laboratory parameters shows that there was a statistically significant improvement, but Yava is found to be more effective on both parameters. Effect of Yava and Jai on Pratyatma Lakshan parameters shows that there was a statistically significant improvement in Alasya Daurbalya, and Yava also process extremely significant changes in Gaurava. Other Pratyatma Lakshan such as Chalaspika, etc. also show consistent improvement, but the level of statistically significance was not quite significant. This shows that if the intake of this food is increased, the effect would be significant. Conclusion. In this study, our aim was evaluate the anti-obesity effect of the flour of barley and oats on body composition in overweight men and women. The group receiving the chapatis of barley flour tended to have greater weight loss, significant reduction in abdomen, waist, hip, skin, fold, thickness, circumferences. Also found to be significant in reducing serum cholesterol, serum triglyceride, VLDL and LDL. Although chapati from oat flour also showed significant result, but barley is found to be much better than oat. Therefore, we can say that barley is effective on inhibition or prevention of various diseases caused by uncontrolled adiposogenesis and lipolysis. Thus, barley and oats can be used in following disorders as a pathya ahar. It is also mentioned as pathya in many Ayurvedic texts. This study proves the indications of Yava over Jai is mentioned in many Ayurvedic texts. It is to be noted that oats are more popular due to better marketing and barley is actually more effective. Many modern texts also describe that oats should not be used as the sole article of diet for the long time, even with the addition of milk. An account of this tendency to produce a skin eruption due to the irritating qualities of avenin, one of its ingredients. So it is advisable not to use oat for long time. Thank you. Thank you very much for listening to me. Can I hear you?
We'll be taking a few questions from Dr. Vijay's study.
Madam, the roti of Yava and Jai was the only thing given to the overweight persons? Only one roti?
No, no, not only one roti. 150 gram flour.
In addition to his...
three roti.
No, okay, three rotis. In addition to his normal diet.
Yeah.
Okay.
Except Gehu roti. This Yava roti, you prefer.
Thank you very much, Dr. Vaidya. Please collect your certificate.